Shalawa Machiam Brakata Yao Brakata Yawashai Brakata Yahweh Brakata Yawashai. Double honors to the elders of Great Millstone. Much love and respect to you brothers out there doing the work of sincerity of truth. Yao Bashim Yawashai Wahakwadash Brakatam Akium. Alright, I'm just coming back with another video here on my lunch break real quick. Just basically gonna speak on how when you go onto the highways and the byways, when you're called when the Spirit of the Lord is on you to go out to the highways and the byways, you go to your nearest and immediate chief concourse of place there in your own city, man. All right, you go there either downtown or wherever the Spirit of the Lord puts you at, but you go to your nearest town, your nearest city where you live and where you reside at, man. All right, unless there's a main headquarters of camp, the main camp there in your state, your city. Then yeah, you would travel to be with them brothers to go out to the highways and the byways, you know. But if it's you by yourself, you're supposed to go straight to your nearest downtown area or wherever there may be a large amount of people, you know what I'm saying? So basically, I just want to bring out a scripture, just going into that a little bit. This is in the book of Luke, chapter 4, verse 16. And he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up. All right, yeah, we know Yahweh Shai. He went everywhere, man. You know, he went everywhere there in that region. You know, and then Paul went abroad, you know what I'm saying, to the Gentiles and things of that nature. You know, but as brothers don't have the ability and means to be traveling to state to state or, you know, doing stuff like that, you know, every now and then you may be able to do it. But when you're called, you're supposed to go to where you're brought up. You know, you go out to the highways and the byways there in your town, and then if you know, you shake the dust off your feet, if nobody's feeling it there, then you go to the downtown area. You know, it says, and he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, talking about Yahweh Shai. And his custom was, he went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day and stood up for to read. And there was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Esaias, was Isaiah. And when he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord resteth upon me. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are abused, or bruised, Salakia, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord." And that's what we do. We go onto the highways and the byways and we speak to the air. Because the Spirit, that's how the Spirit is, man. The Spirit's going to go into where it needs to go. You know, you don't have to call everybody out and let them know this, that, and the third. You speak the word, the Spirit's dealing with them, is going to bring them in. It's going to guide them to a camp, to a brother that's out there preaching. Okay. Verse 20, and he closed the book and he gave it again to the minister and sat down, and the eyes of all them that were in the synagogue were fasted on him. And he began to say unto them, this day is this scripture fulfilled in your ears. All bear him witness and wondered at the gracious words which proceeded out of his mouth. And they said, is not this Joseph's son? And this is why they don't go out into their own city or town. And this is why they don't go to the chief place of concourse in their city or town in the downtown area, because they're going to be seen of co-workers. They're going to be seen of friends, other family members, perhaps enemies that they had in the world. This is why they don't go to the chief place of concourse, because they're going to be recognized. You see what I'm saying? It's easy to go into a different state, a whole completely different area. Nobody knows you, you know? And nobody's going to really give you shit unless they just have a demon is heavily upon them and just don't like what you're saying. You see what I'm saying? But to be spoken of and to be mocked and scoffed at a higher rate is because those people there, they know of you. They know you. And that's what Yahweh Shai went through. Yahweh Shai preached in the ghettos, man. You know? You know what I'm saying? That's why he commanded the apostles, the elders, I mean the disciples that were transformed into apostles, to go abroad and to the Gentiles. You see? They said, "Is not this Joseph's son?" And he said unto them, "You will surely say unto me this proverb, Physician, heal thyself. Whatsoever we have heard done in Capernaum, do also here in thy country." And that's when he was crucified. They're mocking him, saying, "Oh, this is the man that did all these things, but he can't even deliver his own self." They were mocking and scoffing him. 24. And he said, "Verily I say unto you, no prophet is accepted in his own country." That's right. You see? It says, "But I tell you of a truth, many widows were in Israel in the days of Elias," which is Elijah, "when the heaven was shut up 3 years and 6 months, when great famine was throughout all the land. But unto none of them was Elias sent, save unto Sarepta, a city of Zidon, unto a woman that was a widow. And many lepers were in Israel in the time of Elias the prophet," which is Elisha. "And none of them was cleansed, saving Naaman the Syrian. And all they in the synagogue, when they heard these things, were filled with wrath." You see, because he was breaking things down, man. He was confessing the truth. Bearing witness to the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, of his father, of himself. "And all they in the synagogue, when they heard these things, were filled with wrath, and rose up and thrust him out of the city, and led him unto the brow of the hill whereon their city was built, that they might cast him down headlong. But he, passing through the midst of them, went his way." You see? So Yahweh Bashem Yahushai was delivered, you know. He escaped their evil and wicked device, you know. But that was in his own country. That was in his own, where he was brought up, where he was raised up, man. They did this to him. You know, they saw his works, you know, they heard him speak. But this is why they don't go into their own town, into their own city. You see? So it would behoove brothers, younger brothers, man, you know. A lot of you brothers, you're going to do what you got to do. You're going to do exactly what the elders and the leaders and the examples, the true examples are going to tell you. You're going to do exactly what you see and what is told of you. You're going to go out to the highways and the byways there in your city, your town, you know, unless the spirit's on you to go to a main camp, because there's basically a main camp in every major city, man. Every major state or every state, there's a camp. All right. So, let me go ahead and bring out the book of Proverbs, chapter 1. Start at Proverbs 1:20. "Wisdom cries without; she uttereth her voice in the streets. She crieth in the chief place of concourse." She don't hide in the damn alleyway. All right, behind buildings and businesses that were once businesses, you know, buildings, you know, that are closed and things of that nature, man. You know what I'm saying? "Wisdom cried without; she uttered her voice in the streets. She cried in the chief place of concourse, and the openings of the gates in the city. She uttered her words, saying." So she uttereth her words in the chief place of concourse, man, where there's people at. You know, a diversity. All right. So that's receiving proper instruction. Okay? By going out to your nearest town, your nearest city, right? Where you live at, you go to your nearest downtown area, or where you have a chief place of concourse of traffic. All right. "Saying, how long, ye simple ones, will you love simplicity? And the scorners delight in their scorning, and fools hate knowledge. Turn you at my reproof. Behold, I will pour out my word, my spirit unto you. I will make known my words unto you." That's what we be saying to these people out there, man. You know, whether they hear or forbear. Okay? Because I have called, you refused. I have stretched out my hand, and no man regarded. But you have set it not on my counsel, and with none of my reproof. I also will laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your fear cometh. When your fear cometh as desolation, and your destruction cometh as a whirlwind, when distress and anguish cometh upon you, then shall they call upon me, but I will not answer. They shall seek me early, but thou shalt not find me. For that they hated knowledge, and did not choose the fear of the Lord. You see? They didn't fear the Lord, man. They didn't choose knowledge, man. They choose the wisdom of this world. But basically what I'm saying is that the wisdom is going to be in the chief place of concourse. All right? You ain't got to travel 2 hours or an hour and a half away from your original city or town where you're from just to push the word out, man. You know? But that in scripture say, be not ashamed of the gospel, nor be ashamed of the testimony of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. All right? But that's the reason why they don't go out to their own city and town. It's because they're going to be tested by the people that know them from there. All right? So I'm going to go ahead and leave it with that. You brothers out there, stay strong.